When human immune system attacks its own tissue, it is called autoimmune process. Sometimes immune system attacks and damage brain or spinal cord. More specifically, insulating covers of nerve cells, which is called myelin. Myelin sheath of neurons is damaged. This process is called demyelination. Demyelination of nerve cells causes their destruction and loss of function. Multiple sclerosis is the most common demyelinating disease. Symptoms can vary, depending of location and damage strength. Lesions are disseminated in time and space. That's why it is called multiple sclerosis. Typical symptoms include sensory, loss of sensation, paresthesia, dysesthesias, numbness, tingling, itching, and burning. Vision problems including vision loss and double vision. Vestibular symptoms, vertigo and gait imbalance. Difficulty speaking, difficulty swallowing. Motoric symptoms, weakness, tremor, muscle spasticity, and fatigue. Urinary and bowel symptoms, urinary and bowel incontinence, retention and urgency. Constipation, diarrhea, and reflux. Cognitive symptoms, memory impairment. Impairment of executive functions. Trouble concentrating. Psychiatric symptoms, depression and anxiety, erectile dysfunction, and other sexual problems. The condition is often mild early on in the disease and worsens as time progresses. Multiple sclerosis' common presentation is relapsing remitting, which means disease symptoms become worse over time. It is called relapsing, and followed by periods of less severe symptoms that do not completely cease. Called remitting, generally multiple sclerosis is detected between the ages of 20 and 40. Risk factors, environmental factors, including exposure to viral and bacterial agents such as Epstein-Barr virus, human herpes virus type 6, mycoplasma pneumonia, smoking, vitamin deficiency, and exposure to UV radiation are associated with the onset of multiple sclerosis. Also, genetic factors represents additional risk factor. Risk rate in monozygotic twins that have 100% genetic similarity is approximately 25%. For relatives, 1 to 2%. Diagnosis: there is no single diagnostic test for multiple sclerosis. Diagnosis made based on clinical symptoms, magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, and cerebrospinal fluid, CSF, an analysis. The diagnosis is based on evidence of at least two different lesions, plaques or scars, in the white matter of the CNS, two, at least two different episodes in the disease course, and three, chronic inflammation of the CNS, as determined by analysis of the CSF, the inflammatory criterion. Currently, there is no definite cure for multiple sclerosis. However, immunomodulating and anti-inflammatory agents can diminish its progression and decrease some of the pathological symptoms. Immunomodulating agents, including interferon beta and glutamer acetate, are used in non-symptomatic. Others agents also used. Ascorticosteroids inhibit lymphocyte proliferation and secretion of pro-inflammatory cytokines. Mitoxantrone inhibit macrophage-mediated myelin degradation and diminish the production of pro-inflammatory cytokines. Cyclophosphamide increases Th2 cells. Mycophenolate inhibits immune cell activation and migration through the blood-brain barrier. Generally, these agents do not halt the ongoing progression of neurodegeneration. Therefore, other strategies such as stem cell-based therapy are proposed as potential novel paradigms for the treatment of multiple sclerosis. Prognosis: almost 40% of people with multiple sclerosis reach the seventh decade of life. Although most people lose the ability to walk before death, 90% are capable of independent walking at 10 years from onset, and 75% at 15 years. Life expectancy is 5 to 10 years lower than that of the unaffected population.